Hello and welcome to math. Today we're going to multiply and not divide, none of that, radical expressions. By the end of this video, you're going to be able to multiply and the radical expressions. You're going to be able to multiply radical expressions and solve geometric problems as well. Geometric radical problems. So that's fantastic. I know exactly what you wanted to do today. So let us go about mathing. So here, what is the simplified form of each expression? And I think you guys probably bossed it out with the adding and subtracting. So let's get a little bit more complicated. Let's multiply. And here we have to start with distributing. So the square root of 10 times square root of 6 is the square root of 60 plus 3 square roots of 10. Now, we need to see if we can simplify anything underneath the radical. So can I simplify anything in the radicand? And your math sense is just, like, impeccable, and you realize, hey, wait, square root of 60, you mean square root of 4 times square root of 15? And I say, yes, I do mean that. Square root of 4 is just 2, so this would be rewritten as 2 square roots of 15 plus 3 square roots of 10. And that's all you can simplify down to, because the radicands, the numbers underneath the radical symbols, are not similar at all. The expressions are not similar underneath the radical symbols, so that's as far as I can go. So let's try the next one. A little bit more challenging. Some of you probably eyed it up already, but this just deals with some double distribution. So first, square root of 6 times the square root of 6. I think we can know that that's just going to be equal to 6. I hope so. I'm hoping. I know. Giant leaps here. Plus square root of 18. And then make sure you take that whole negative with it. That would be negative 2 square roots of 18. Right there. Minus 2 square roots of 9. And you may already say, hey, Mr. Herb, wait a minute. Square root of 3 times square root of 3. Isn't that just 3? And can I just do negative 2 times 3 and get negative 6? Yeah, you can. Good for you. So what we realize here is, hey, wait a minute. Those 6s cancel out. And I'm just left with what's inside here. So a positive 1 square root of 18 minus 2 square roots of 18 will be negative square root of 18. And you break down the square root of 18 as just the square root of 9 times the square root of 2, still negative, and that'll just be negative 3 square roots of 2. And that's it. That's your final answer. Good for you. Proud of you. Now, I won't be proud of you if you just try to distribute that 2 to everything inside. That is not math. Don't do that. That's horrible. It's abomination. Don't do it. So what I need to do is I need to rewrite this as square root of 6 minus 3 times the square root of 6 minus 3, because that's what that means. That's what these two things are equal. That's math, and it's beautiful. So just accept it. And right now, I'm just going to have to double distribute again. Square root of 6 times square root of 6 is 6. Minus 3 square roots of 6. Minus 3 square roots of 6. Plus 9. So from there, I can combine what I can combine. These have the same radicand, so I can combine those. And 6 plus 9 is 15. So that would be 15 minus 6 radical 6. And that's it. That's all I can simplify down, because you can't simplify anything in the radicand any further. So I know what you're thinking. Mr. Herb, let me try. And I say, go right ahead. Pause the video here. Try these problems. And when you're done, I'll reveal the answers. For this first one, you should have gotten 2 square roots of 3 plus 5 square roots of 2. And the second one, you should have gotten negative 6 square root of 2 minus 6. Now, if you got that, fast forward. If not, I'm going to explain some things. So, square root of 2 times square root of 6 is square root of 12 plus 5 square roots of 2. So we kind of already see that square root of 2 coming. And if I want to break this down, I can break that down to square root of 4 times the square root of 3 plus 5 square roots of 2, of course. And that will give me 2 square roots of 3 plus 5 square roots of 2. Final answer. This one is a bit more complicated. Let's move that up because we need to double distribute or double distribute, however you want to say it. I don't English well. So I'm going to multiply and I'm going to get 4 radical 18 plus 3 radical 36. We'll talk about that in a second. And then that's a negative again. So minus 8 radical 9 minus 6 radical 18. Now, let's talk about a few things first. One, some of you probably already thought, hey, wait a minute, square root of 6 plus or times 3 square roots of 6, isn't that just 3 times 6, which would be 18? And you're right. I can just break this down to 3 times, oh, no, not radical 6, 3 times 6, and that would just be 18. And the same thing goes here. Negative 8 times the square root of 9 would just be negative 8 times 3, or negative 24. Now I realize that these have the same radicand, so I can combine those into negative 2 square roots of 18. But I think by now we've kind of seen that I can break down square root of 18 into square root of 9 times the square root of 2. I couldn't make it rhyme anymore. I'm sorry. And then 18 minus 6 is, or 18 minus 24 is negative 6. Simplifying this down, that would be negative 6 square roots of 2 minus 6. Let us move on. And I know what you're thinking. How about some geometry? And I'm thinking you're thinking good thoughts. So let's try this one. If for whatever reason you have somehow forgotten the area of a rectangle, which is horrible and you should remember it right now, it's just area of the base, or it's just base times height. So I would rewrite this as square root of 3x times the square root of 6x plus 5. And now I just have to multiply. So that would be 18, the square root of 18x squared plus 5 square roots of 3x. And I hope by now we've realized that we can break down the square root of 18 to 3 square roots of 2. And I have that square root of x squared, which we know is just x. So this is really 3x square roots of 2 plus 5 square roots of 3x. And that's all I can do. That's all I can simplify it down to. Just those two things right there, because nothing in the radicand simplifies down any further. All right, let's move on. Let's get triangular. And triangles have an area of 1/2 the base times the height. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to say 1/2 times the square root of 7y times the square root of 14y to the third. And here I'm going to break down that 14 into 7 times 2. And the reason I do that is because 7 times 7 is just 7 squared. So this is 7 squared times 2 times y to the fourth, and the square root of all of those things. But the square root of 7 squared is just 7. And the square root of y to the fourth, square root of y to the fourth is just y squared. So really, I'm just left with radical 2 under there. So half of 7 is 7 halves. So 7 halves y squared, square roots of 2. And that would be my final answer. And we probably want something like unit squared here to make it official. But that's all you got to do. And that's your final answer. So let us move on to circles. Here, the area of a circle is pi r squared. Pi r squared. And not 2 pi r. You're thinking of circumference here. But we want to just do pi r squared. So I have pi times the square root of 3x minus 2 squared. And you remember that that just makes my soul angry if you just try to distribute that 2 everywhere. So you rewrite it as the square root of 3x minus 2 times the square root of 3x minus 2. And then I do the double distribution. So 3x minus 2 square roots of 3x minus 2 square roots of 3x plus 4. Again, all still times pi. That simplifies down to 3x minus 4 square roots of 3x plus 4, and all of that pi units squared. And that's all you can simplify. That's it. That's as simplified as it gets. And I know you're saying that's already pretty simplified, but it's really not. It looks ugly. But that's okay. That's all I can do because you're dealing with radicals. So why don't you try one? Try out these two problems, and when you're done, come watch to see the answers. You should have gotten 5x plus 6 square roots of 5x plus 9, and all of that times pi. And for the triangle, you should have gotten 4x cubed square root of x. If you got those, you did fantastic, and I'm very proud of you, and you can stop watching. If not, I'm going to keep explaining. So a equals pi r squared, or pi times the square root of 5x plus 3 squared, which is pi times the square root of 5x plus 3 times the square root of 5x plus 3. And I do the double distribution, and I get 5x plus 3 square roots of 5x. And you guessed it, plus 3 square roots of 5x plus 9, and all of these things times pi. So that simplifies down to 5x plus 6 square roots of 5x plus 9 pi units squared, and that would be the area of that circle with a radius of the square root of 5x plus 3. So let's do the other one. All right. Here, area of a triangle, 1/2 the base times the heights. So that means 1/2 times the square root of 2x times the square root of 32x to the 6. Multiply everything underneath first. It could probably help you out. You can probably already figure out I can make that just x cubed, but we'll get to that in a second. So that would be 1/2 times the square root of 64x to the 7th. Now, we know the square root of 64 is just 8. And I can kind of already know that the square root of 7 is just going to be x cubed square roots of x. And if you didn't get that, that's because x to the 7th can be broken down to, the square root of x to the 7th can be broken down to the square root of x to the 6th times the square root of x, just kind of to the 1st. Square root of x to the 6th is x cubed, and there you have it. And 1/2 of 8 is 4, so 4x cubed square roots of x. And that'll be our area, unit squared. All right. Thank you for watching, and make sure you take all the good notes. If you have any questions, let us know. And that's all I got for now. Bye-bye now.